We're going to start studying curves in the plane, and there are three ways to describe a curve in the plane, and that these are related to three kinds of functions. Now, when I say the word function, you're probably thinking of something like f of x equals x squared, which has one input and one output. You put a number in, you get a number out, that's a function, right? And you probably are also thinking of a picture of that function, and you get a picture of that function by making one axis be the input, the other axis be the output, and we usually call the input x, and we usually call the output y, and then we take all possible values of our input, and we feed them to the function, and we see what kind of output we get, and lo and behold, we get a curve. The curve is y equals f of x, or you can just as well write y equals x squared in this case. And if you were interested in the geometry of this curve, like you pick a point here, let's say this is the point 2, 4, and you ask what's the slope of the tangent line at 2, 4, well, you know how to do that. You learn that taking a derivative is a good way to compute the slope of a tangent line. And if I asked you what is the area under the curve, you'd know to take an integral of that. So you get lots of curves by looking at graphs of functions. And the properties of those curves are closely related to the properties of those functions. Okay. Now, there is another kind of curve, another kind of function where you have two inputs and one output. And we use this to describe curves like circles. A circle is not the graph of a function. It fails the vertical line test. Instead, for a circle, what we're really looking at is the solutions to an equation, x squared plus y squared equals 1. And what's essentially going on is we've got a function of two variables. F of xy is x squared plus y squared equals 1. And this circle is all of the points where f of x, y equals 1. It's called the level set of a function. Now, if you looked at all the points where f of x, y was a quarter, you'd get a different circle. If you looked at all the points where f of x, y was 4, you'd get a different circle. So each of these circles is described by the same function. And, you know, we could fill in, if you set this function equal to your favorite number, you'll get a certain set of points in the plane. And it's all due to thinking of a function of two variables. Now, there's an important aspect here. The axes are no longer input and output. X and Y are both inputs. There's no way of showing the output. Now, sometimes when you have f of x, y equals x squared plus y squared, you draw a three-dimensional surface and let z equals x squared plus y squared. We're not going to do that here. We're just saying the function is x squared plus y squared, and if you set that equal to a number, you get a curve. The last way to get a curve has to do with vector-valued functions. These are functions with one input and several outputs. So we're going to put in an input and call it t, and then we're going to get both x and y as outputs. So in other words, we're sitting at the point x is a function of time and y is a function of time. And that's your location at time t. And let's see how you can describe the first two kinds of curves with a vector-valued function. If you look at a parabola, you could always describe this parabola. Actually, let's find all three ways for the parabola. For the parabola, we got it as y equals x squared. We could also write it as the curve x squared minus y equals 0. So that's saying here's a function of two variables, x squared minus y, and we're looking at where that's 0. And we can also get it by saying let x equal t and y equals t squared. If you let x and y both be functions of time, we have more than just the curve. We have a trajectory. We're here at time 0. We're here at time 1. We're here at time 2. We're here at time negative 1. We don't just have a curve. We have an itinerary for the entire curve. At every point in time, we have a particular point on the curve. If you do that for the circle, for a circle, we can imagine going clockwise around a circle, counterclockwise around a circle with speed 1, so that after time t, you've gone an angle t around the circle, in which case the coordinates of this point would be cosine of t and sine of t. So in other words, to get a circle, you can parametrize a circle by letting x equals cosine of t, and letting y equal sine of t. So you can describe functions in three ways, as the graph of an ordinary function, where you let y equals f of x, as a set of points where a function of two variables takes a particular value, or via a parametrization, where we give you both x and y as a function of time, and just imagine a trajectory. We're here at time 0, we're here at time pi over 2, we're here at time pi, we're here at time 3 pi over 2, we're back to where we started at time 2 pi. We'll talk more about parametrized curves and a particular example of parametrized curves in the next video.